Hi guys, here we are on the electrical test area. This test is made to ensure that there is no short and open on the circuit board.
Yeah, and I know there is two kind of machines that we can use here.
Yes, now you are an expert, Clément.
Kind of.
We have the flying probe and the bed of nails machine. Let's have a look.
The flying probe test is the latest technology in terms of electrical tests. This control technique has emerged with the HDI circuit, which is more and more common. This is one of the most impressive stages in the PCB journey. The Gerber file is read by the machine. The operator places the boards within a panel or alone. Then the 4, 6, or 8 probes, distributed on each side, start their work. Send an electric charge to the circuits while each contact pad will be in continuous contact to ensure that there are no opens or shorts. In the event that there is an electrical problem on the board, an operator will assess the issue. Even if the flying probe test is the latest technology, it is not the fastest one. Indeed, each time it is necessary to change the boards manually. To sum things up, the tooling is cost-effective. It is most common to use it for prototyping and small series, and it is also suitable for HDI circuit boards. There are also drawbacks, such as the longer cycle operation due to the manual work between each of the boards, which greatly extends the testing time. While tooling for the flying probe test was cost-effective, the universal grid test, also known as bed of nails, requires a test device that costs significantly more. The test setup is designed based on the Gerber file, so it is different for each circuit board. The operator must insert many pins of different sizes to cover the entire test area. The preparation is extremely expensive and tedious. Once done, the holes are aligned with the test points of the circuit board, and all the test points are checked at the same time, making it very fast and reliable. To sum things up, the bed of nails is perfect for mass production, with its shorter cycle operation between each PCB. There are also drawbacks, mainly with the expensive tooling, the tedious preparation, and the density limits.
So, now the electrical test is finished, we are sure that the circuitry is correct.
Coming up next is a final inspection. Stay tuned.